Hello everyone, welcome to Vivek IS Career Academy YouTube channel. Topic for today's lecture is from health section of science and technology. Once again, a disease is in news and the country in question is once again China. So in today's lecture, we will discuss the topic of bubonic plague. We already are battling a pandemic, and to hear about such disease is already setting alarm bells in China. So the Inner Mongolia region of China, the autonomous region, and Baiyanur to be precise, is the region where two confirmed cases of bubonic plague have been confirmed, which has set alarm bells already in health authorities, and they have raised the alert level to level 3, which is quite a serious one. So this disease is not a some novel disease. It has been there for centuries, and it is also known as Black Death. So we will discuss what are the causative agents, what are the reservoirs, how this disease is transmitted from one person to another, and all the historical facts associated with it, because this is one of the topics which is once again important from prelims point of view. So first of all, whenever such disease is in news, the first thing you need to cover is the causative agent. And since it's a vector-borne disease, so even the name of vector becomes important. So here I have just drawn a small diagram. You can see that there are three living organisms involved. The first organism which I have classified are rodents. Rodents is a common group which includes the rat, mice, the bat, badger, as well as squirrels. So all these small sized mammals are the likely reservoir of all the such diseases. So in this case, whenever these organisms come in contact with a flea, flea are insects. Okay? These are the flightless insects which feed on blood or stick to the skin of such animals. And these are the vectors which transmit the infectious agent to the host. And once again, you have to understand the causative agent here is a bacterium. Like in the last lecture, when we were covering the swine fever as well as the G4 virus, the causative agent was a viral species. But here, this is the most important point, that causative agent which these reservoir organisms are harboring is Yersinia pestis. This is the scientific name of bacteria. Just like in TB, we had discussed mycobacterium tuberculosis. In case of plague, it's the name of a bacteria. So bacteria is in harboring in this organism, and this flea transmits this bacteria into the human beings, and that's where the problem actually starts. So in case of vector, you have to choose flea. Causative agent, you have to choose the bacteria. And if they ask about their likely reservoir species, then the rat, rodent, or they will likely to use the word rodent itself. Now, such diseases in which animals are involved, these are called zoonotic. Because in 2020, this term is not an alien term for you. Right from the coronavirus to African swine flu, all such diseases come under, including Nipah, zoonotic category. Zoonotic category diseases are which can be transmitted from an animal to a human being. And in case of plague, human to human transmission is also possible. So how is this transmission possible? The first angle is infected bite by infected flea. This is the through which the animal is likely to transmit to the humans. But once the human is infected, the system affected here is the lymphatic system. We all have lymph nodes which play a role in immunity. So these lymph nodes get swollen up, and quite a bulge is formed in your lymphatic systems. And this is a swollen lymph are called buboes. B-U-B-O-E-S. You call it bubo. So this is where the term bubonic plague comes into the picture. The swollen lymph node. And when they burst, at times that human being coming in contact with such tissue, infected tissues, infection can be transmitted. So once again, it's a communicable disease. And also, when this infection spreads to your respiratory system, lungs, then the droplet infection mode once again gets activated. So even the sneezing, coughing episode is likely to transmit infection in case of an active case. So you should be careful about the all three modes by which this disease can spread. So in the system affected, in bubonic plague, it's the lymphatic system which you have to pick. But there are other types as well, which we call pneumonic and septicemic. Pneumonic plague is the one in which the infection has been transmitted to respiratory system and lungs are involved. The fatality rate is quite high in case of the pneumonic plague. It's almost 60 to 100%. And once the infection enters the blood, it is called septicemic plague. In that case, also fatality rate is quite high. In case of bubonic plague, it varies from 30 to 60. If it rests untreated, it can be fatal as well. Even the RO number, the reproduction number which we call the basic multiplication number, is around 5 to 6. A single person who is infected is likely to transmit the infection to 5 to 6 people, if not a control, which is quite significant. So this is why this disease is quite a dreaded one once the outbreak is detected. If we go back to the history, it was Yersinian plague which dominated the course of ancient history. In 6th century, there was Rome was ruled by Justinian, the Indian emperor, and at his tenure this outbreak was there. And almost 50 million people were killed in that plague. And the more recent one, we could say, it was in 14th century. That was not limited to Europe, it was in Asia and spread in Africa as well. And that also caused 50 million casualties, which is a quite high number. In case of India, the first documented or official known case were in 1896 in Bombay. And that's where the term, in 14th century, the Black Death started to sing. Because in septicemic plague, it is seen the skin turns black. And that's why it is called Black Death. So in 1896 Bombay plague, once again, there were 12 million deaths were reported. And subsequently, 1897 Epidemic Prevention Act was passed, which is currently in use. When we are trying to control the corona, you can see a lot of provisions are under Epidemic Prevention Act. So that landmark legislation was after effect, because in India we have seen this is a reactionary approach to the legislation, and this is where the reactionary approach came into being, even though that time it was the British India time. So it's not that it's unlike the current coronavirus, there is no vaccine or treatment. This disease is curable because it is caused by a bacteria. So we all know in case of bacteria, antibiotics comes into the picture. You don't have to memorize the exact name of streptomyces, doxycycline, and another antibiotic. It's just that the treatment is available, and intravenous fluids as well as these antibiotics can be given, and it can be managed. The key angle is that we have to prevent the community spread or the transmission. The early diagnosis, it will help in subsiding. Currently, only 3 countries are considered to be endemic, because this disease is not limited to just Europe or Asia, Africa. It is found in, has been reported in known history across all the continents except Antarctica. So currently the Congo, Peru and Madagascar, these 3 countries are considered endemic countries where their cases have been there. But the recent one in the current outbreak, which is dominating headlines, is from Inner Mongolia region of China. So make sure you are covering these places in news if you are targeting the state service exam as well. So the treatment, you will end up by saying an antibiotic. Vaccine is not quite effective one, so WHO has not recommended it unless there is a high risk zone. So this is what we had to cover in case of bubonic. Let's hope that it subsides and it's just a nightmare phase we are already having through the current COVID pandemic, and we are back to our work and resume our healthy life which we were resuming pre-corona phase. So I hope I have covered all the pillars. And still, if you have any sort of doubts which have not been addressed in this lecture, you can ask them in comment section, and I'll be more than happy to answer your queries. There's a practice question as well, which has been posted. You can try answering it. So So I'll be back soon with another current affair lecture. So stay tuned. Thank you very much.